My previous best image of Jupiter held the title for 6 whole days, because I thought there was no way that I could image Jupiter at opposition 2 years in a row. And I set up 6 days earlier on October 27th because the forecast told me to. But the day before opposition, the skies started to clear, and the forecast said it was going to be clear on November 2nd. So I kept my fingers crossed, and to my surprise, the night of November 2nd, the skies were clear. It was a little bit hazy, but it was clear nonetheless, and I took advantage. So I set up the exact same way as the previous Friday and imaged Jupiter. I ended up getting about 2 hours of images of Jupiter, and I even live streamed it on my channel. Thanks to everyone who joined in. It was a lot of fun interacting with all of you and going over my setup in real time. It was really fun, and I hope to do it again soon. Anyways, back to my image. I focused the telescope the exact same way as the night before by using a button-off mask on the bright Galilean moons. For my image settings, I used 341 gain and between 18 and 22 milliseconds of exposure. I used a higher exposure than the last time because I think the haze was making the planet look a little bit dimmer, so to get the exact same brightness, I upped my exposure. And I took 62 videos at 1000 frames each, and they ranged from 20 to 25 seconds each, depending on what my FPS was. About 20 minutes after I stopped live streaming, I got the crispiest video of Jupiter that night. This video doesn't look like much, but you can make out the great red spot and the bands on the planet very clearly. I took this video and stacked it in AutoStakkert, then did some sharpening, wavelets, and white balancing in AstroSurface, and then some minor saturation adjustments in Photoshop. This is now my best shot of Jupiter. I batch processed the rest of the images into a time lapse. Some of the frames look blurrier, and that's because I was dealing with atmospheric haze and atmospheric turbulence, so it looked hazier when I was capturing them. And we saw that on the live stream. I'm sorry I wasn't able to live stream the crispiest part of Jupiter, but maybe I'll get another chance the next week or so while Jupiter is still big and bright in the sky. I'm hoping to do a live stream of the moon in an upcoming live stream, so stay tuned for that. That should be a fun one. And I'm planning on doing more hydrogen alpha streaming of the sun as practice for the April 8th total solar eclipse. For now, enjoy the time lapse of Europa, Ganymede, Io, and Jupiter. Until next time, clear skies.